Hello friends, now in one of the session we have discussed about the SCBA apparatus, that is self-contained breathing apparatus, and we have discussed the breathing apparatus parts, what is the mechanism, then what are the different testing procedures, etc. And in that we have clearly focused that one of the IEC standard is very much useful regarding this breathing apparatus. That IEC standard is 10245 1996. So under this 10245, there are various parts, and especially we are talking about the part one in this session and part two in the next session. So part one of this IS-10245 is related to the closed circuit breathing apparatus, that is compressed oxygen cylinder specification. Now, what exactly the contents of this IS-10245 part 1? So under that, first point is related to the scope. So what is the scope of this IS standard for this breathing apparatus and closed circuit? So it refers to the design, construction, performance, and laboratory and practical tests for the closed circuit types of breathing apparatus. So there are two points, closed circuit type, and second one is open circuit types. So open circuit type is in the part two, and in this part only closed circuit type. So related to the design aspects, construction aspects, performance, and laboratory and practical test for this closed circuit type, that is the main scope of this IS-10245 for the breathing apparatus. So closed circuit means the wearer is going to breathe the air and exhale the air. So inhale the air and exhale the air, that is the common phenomena and the natural process. So the exhaled air is rebreathed by the wearer. So after the carbon dioxide concentration has been effectively reduced, the oxygen concentration is enriched. So after exhaling the air, the CO2 is going to reduce and we can supply the oxygen with the help of oxygen cylinder or the compressed oxygen cylinder. So after mixing this oxygen with purified gas, and the mixture can be inhaled by the wearer. So that is the basic idea regarding this breathing apparatus, and the main concept is closed circuit type of breathing apparatus. So this standard includes breathing apparatus which operate on liquid oxygen and chemically produced oxygens. So it is not related to that oxygen supply, that is from the liquid oxygen or the chemically produced oxygen. So it is related to the only compressed oxygen cylinder. So the references in this IS is clearly mentioned in the annexure A. So we will look after about this different annexure like A, B, C, D, E, F. Now, with reference to this annexure A, that clearly gives us the idea regarding the references in the text constitute provisions of the standards. And at the time of publication, the editions are indicated where valid. So we have to check the date also, we have to check the latest edition, and then we have to follow all the standards. So these standards are subject to revisions. So there may be a revision, and after that revision, we have to again study this latest standard, and then only we have to follow the standards. Then third point is related to the terminology. So there are various definitions involved under these IEC standards, like working duration. So what is that working duration? The maximum period of time for which the apparatus should be used. So this is closed circuit type breathing apparatus. So for that apparatus, the maximum period of time for which this apparatus should be used is called as working duration. Then next definition is effective duration. So the time, that is the addition of working duration plus a reserve period of at least 10 minutes. If it is the apparatus which is used for 45 minutes working duration, then we have to reserve 10 minutes for that apparatus. And if it is of 75 minute working duration apparatus, then we have to reserve 30 minutes, that is the 20% of this working durations. So we have to check whether the apparatus is of 45 minutes or whether it is of 75 minutes. According to that, we have to reserve some of the duration for returning that particular VRR in the safe position or in the safe location. So for that purpose, if that is 45 minutes working duration, we have to check at least 10 to 15 minutes for the reserve. And if it is of 75 minutes, then 30 minutes. So that total duration is called as effective duration. Then inhaled air, so atmosphere breathe in by the VRR is simply inhaled air, and the atmosphere breathe out by the VRR is called as exhaled air. Then the fourth point is requirements. So what is the requirement for this closed type breathing apparatus or closed circuit breathing apparatus? So under that, the sub point is method of operation. So under this construction part, the method of operation is what? So rather than discussing this descriptive type of text, I will show you the actual or the schematic diagram of this closed circuit self-contained breathing apparatus. So this is the oxygen cylinder where from we can supply this oxygen towards this breathing bag. So from this oxygen can be supplied to this area that is in the breathing bag. Then the purified air, so here it is a purifier. This purified air is going to mix into the oxygen that is in the breathing bag area, and then this breathing bag area where the oxygen, that is fresh oxygen, as well as the purified air, that mixture can be inhaled by the VRR after cooling that gases. So this is the cooler region. Then after cooling this mixture gases, that is air, purified air plus oxygen, so that mixture of gases can be inhaled by the VRR through this face piece or mouthpiece. And then after breathing that air, the air which is exhaled by that VRR, so that exhaled air can pass through this exhalation wall. And this air can be again purified by this purifier. So again, this purified air is going to mix in the breathing bag. Then some oxygen is going to pass through the breathing bag with the help of this compressed oxygen cylinder. And again, the process is continued. So this is the cycle, and this is the simple working principle of this self-contained breathing apparatus, that is the closed circuit breathing apparatus. Then for this oxygen, we have to check the pressure gauge, because we have to check the pressure in the green zone, that is the sufficient amount of pressure is there or not. If it is not, then we have to return from that confined space. Then here bypass and pressure reducing wall is there. Here the exhalation wall is there. Here the inhalation wall is there. So different types of walls or the different accessories are involved under this self-contained breathing apparatus. Here also the relief wall is there. So depending on the situation, we have to operate these types of wall manually, and some apparatus are in such a way that some walls can be operated automatically. So that depends on the situation. So in this self-contained breathing apparatus, the material should be in a such a way that the properties of the material should be having the adequate mechanical strength, durability, and resistance in deterioration by heat or by contact with sea water or mine water. So we have to avoid the corrosion, we have to avoid the heat, we have to check the mechanical strength as well as the durability of this apparatus. So for that purpose, we have to check the material properties. Such material shall be anti-static and fire resistance. So to avoid the fire, we have to use this anti-static material and fire resistance material wherever possible. This material shall not be made of magnesium, titanium, aluminium, or alloys related to these metals, because this metal can give rise to the frictional spark, and that can be acted as a ignition for the fire. That is why we have to avoid these types of materials. Then this material must have the property like non-staining, soft, pliable, and shall not contain known dermatitis substances. So it should not be harm to your skin. That is why this dermatitis word is there. So it is related to the skin diseases. So we have to use such material that they are not going to affect or adversely affect on our skin. Then we have to check the strength and resistance in water, because if the apparatus is in the water or submerged in the water, then there may be a chances of deflation. Deflation means the air removal from the breathing bag. So there may be a chances of air removal of this from this apparatus through the breathing bag. If it is the case, then there is no supply of mixed air, or there is no supply of air that is called as inhaled air. Then we have to check the separation of parts points. So all this part should be cleaned, examined, and tested on a frequently basis. So we have to check all these fittings, we have to check all these types of wall, we have to check all these types of couplings and pressure gauges, etc. Then this part should be in a such a way that they should be readily accessible and easily distinguishable, because sometimes we have to touch that part, we have to close or open that wall, we have to use some manual operation, etc. So that is why this readily accessible and easily distinguishable part should be preferred. Then mass. So the mass, maximum mass of this breathing apparatus shall not exceed 16 kg, including the breathing fittings. Then the leak tightness. So we have to test all these apparatus, because we are using this compressed oxygen cylinder, and we are using this purifier, we are using this breathing bag, we are using these different types of walls, etc. So we have to check the leakness property. So there should not be any leak from any type of parts or the walls of this apparatus. Then this apparatus should be clean and should be decontaminated from any types of chemical substances, and all these guidelines are described in the annexure B. Then the next part of this apparatus is face piece. So this face piece are not suitable for the persons with beards. So unless special fabrications are made, they will also not be suitable for the wearers with spectacles. So these spectacles, if are having the side arms, then this face piece is not suitable for that wearer. So it is not suitable for the persons having beards or the persons having the spectacles with side arms. So in such situations, if it is the case, then mouthpiece with nose clip should be preferred. So if the person is with beard or with spectacles with side arms, then we have to prefer the mouthpiece with nose clips. Then the component parts of all these face pieces withstand some particular pressure, that is the test under water at an air pressure of 1.7 kilonewtons per meter square, that is kilopascal. So 1.7 kilopascal should be registered by the tubes or the different parts of this apparatus. This piece shall cover all these parts of our body, that is eyes, nose, mouth and chin, and shall provide adequate sealing on the face of wearer of the breathing apparatus. Then with the guidelines of this annexure C, we can test this face piece for the inward leakage. So there should not be a leakage more than 0.05% for the inhaled air. So negligible leakage can be acceptable only. So for that purpose, how to avoid this leakage? We have to check the annexure C in this IS code. Then this face pieces shall be light in mass and comfortable. Then they should minimize the muscular strain, particularly when worn in circumstances involving the vigorous movements, because this 16 kg is not comfortable if you are going for the longer time or if you are moving for the different frequencies. Then this face piece shall be suitable, preferably replaceable eyepieces or eye sheets, and this eyepiece or eye shield shall be made of non-splinterable, clear and non-inflammable material. So to avoid the sharp edges, to avoid the fire, we have to use this non-splinterable and non-inflammable material for this eyepieces or the face pieces. Then this face piece shall be secured to the face by means of an adjustable and replaceable head harness, and they shall be fitted with a strap to support them when not being worn. So there should be some adjustable and replaceable head harness. Then the manufacturer shall provide means to reduce misting, because we have to see that particular situation or the specific situation where we have to work, and that is why this vision is important. So in order to avoid the vision interferences, we have to reduce the misting. And for that purpose, that manufacturer should follow the guidelines in the annexure D. Then the dead space in the face piece shall be as low as possible. So zero dead space is the ideal one. Then the face piece shall be give wide field of vision. There should be some provision for the wipers, that is to avoid the interferences for the vision. So to avoid the different dust or the chemical substances on the face piece, we have to use the manual wipers also. Then the next part of this apparatus is head harness. So the head harness shall hold the face piece or the mouth face. So we have already discussed about that. The head harness shall be adjustable, and if consisting only of straps, then this shall be adjustable and not less than 19 mm width. The head harness strap shall be slip proof and durable. Then the next part of this apparatus is mouthpiece. So if the apparatus is fitted with a mouthpiece, it shall be designed to provide a reliable seal with the mouth. That is the basic and most important requirement with related to the mouthpiece. Then there is a apparatus part that is called as nose clip. So nose clip shall be provided if mouthpiece is used. So if you are going to use mouthpiece instead of face piece due to some circumstances, because sometimes the person may be having the beard, sometimes the person is having the spectacles with the sidearms, then we have to go for the mouthpiece. So if the mouthpiece is going to provide, then we have to use the nose clip, because we have to avoid the slip of the mouthpiece from the nose if the moistures are present or the humidity is more, or the moisture may be present due to the perspiration, and suitable means shall be provided for attaching it to the apparatus to prevent the losses. So that should be a comfortable one to work in the confined spaces with the help of this nose clip. Then the next part is body harness. So the body harness shall be designed to allow the user to use the apparatus quickly and easily without assistance and shall be adjustable for fit. So for all the parts, it is applicable that we have to feel comfortable, and that is why the design aspects are very important. Then buckles fitted to vest and shoulder harness shall be so constructed that once adjusted, they will not slip. That is why these buckles are designed in a nice way. Then if you are going to use any fabric in the body harness, then this fabric used in the construction of body harness shall be resistant to the shrinkage. For certain applications, the body harness shall be detachable to the permit water immersion testing, or the component part shall not retain water. So there is a drop test for this body harness. So this body harness should withstand a drop test of 1 meter when loaded to the 75 kg. It means from 1 meter height, if the load is of 75 kg, then also this body harness can withstand that load with that particular height. Then next point is inhalation and exhalation valves. So we have already discussed about the inhalation air and exhalation air. So for that purpose, to inhale that air and to exhale that air, these valves are used in that apparatus. So this valve shall not be impaired by any heat or the moisture likely to be encountered in the use. So we have to take care about the heat and moisture while using these types of valves. Then the next part is relief valve. So breathing apparatus of the closed circuit type shall be provided with relief valve operated automatically by the pressure in the breathing circuit. So it can be operated automatically and designed so that inward leakage of the external atmosphere shall not exceed 0.0025%. So if it is the case, then the valve is going to operate automatically. And all the testing for this valve is given in the annexure F. Then the breathing apparatus fitted with the manual relief valve shall also be permissible. So automatic valve, that is relief valve, as well as manual relief valve are permissible. Then the performance characteristics of this relief valve is specially related to the pressure, obviously, and the percentage of leakage on which basis these relief valves are going to operate. So the opening pressure of the moist relief valve measured at a constant flow of 1 liter per minute shall be fitted with 50 mm H2O and 40 mm H2O, that is the pressure criteria, in any position of the valve. And there are different resistance. The resistance of the relief valve shall not exceed 50 mm H2O in any orientation of the valve. So when the testing is done, on these two points, that is at 50 liter per minute for set with a continuous flow rate greater than 2 liter per minute, and at 30 liter per minute for set with a continuous oxygen flow rate less than 2 liter per minute. So these are the two conditions where our requirement is that the resistance of this relief valve shall not exceed 50 mmH2. So this is the testing guidelines, and the testing guidelines are given in detail in the annexure F. Then the next part is reducing valve or the pressure reducer. So if the pressure is exceeds, then this valve is going to operate to reduce that pressure. So in the apparatus, using a reducing valve or pressure reducer alone, that it is one supplementary lung governed oxygen supply. The flow of oxygen shall be not less than 4 liters per minute. So this is the basic criteria for that to operate this valve. So the oxygen supply should be more than 4 liters per minute for the effective duration of the apparatus. Then the flow of oxygen from a reducing valve of constant flow type shall remain constant to within 10% of the preset flow at all the cylinder pressures above the 10 atmospheres. And the reducing valve, if adjustable, shall be provided with the suitable locking device to prevent this accidental alteration of this oxygen supply. So in any means, we have to supply this oxygen more than 4 liters per minute. To maintain that, we have to adjust this pressure reducer or the reducing valve. Then the next part is demand valve, that is lung governed oxygen supply. It means that depending on your lung capacity, depending on the situation or the condition or the present condition, sometimes the lungs are going to demand more oxygen supply than the expected one or the average one. So for that purpose, this demand valve can be operated. So initially, after starting this apparatus, the first point or the first inhalation and the demand valve is going to operate. So this demand valve, depending on the supply, may operate or the open at a constant flow rate of 10 liters per minute, but shall not exceed 35 mm water pressure. So if the supply is 2 liters per minute or the less than 2 liters per minutes, then it is the dangerous situation. And that is why 4 liters per minute, that is the main criteria to supply this oxygen. So depending on your breathing, this demand valve is going to operate in a such a way that you may feel comfortable while breathing. So that is the basic criteria for that. Then bypass valve. So apparatus equipped with the pressure reducer, reducing valve, lung governed valve shall be provided with manually operated bypass valve. So that can be self-closing type. So whereby the wearer can obtain a supply of oxygen at a flow between 50 liters per minute and 90 liters per minute at all cylinder pressures above 5000 kilopascal, inadequately of the reducing valve or lung governed valve. So after utilization, if you are feeling comfortable or if you are reaching to the normal situation, normal location and in a safe situation, then you can bypass that oxygen supply, and that is why you can operate this bypass valve, and that is why it is called as self-closing type of valve. So the shape and size of the valve control shall be such that it can be operated even with a wet or slippery hand. So that grip is provided for this valve to operate in a easier mode. Then there is a pressure gauge. So we already discussed that. This is the apparatus in which the compressed oxygen cylinder is used. So compressed oxygen, it means there is some pressure. So for that purpose, we have to use this pressure gauge. We have to test this pressure gauge. We have to calibrate this pressure gauge with reference to the standard guidelines. Then there is a warning device. So after completion or after reaching a particular duration of this device, we have checked that effective duration, because after the completion of the working duration, there is a safe duration that may be of 10 minutes to 15 minutes or sometimes 25 to 30 minutes depending on the capacity of that cylinder. So for that purpose, we have to use this warning device. So this warning device automatically warn to you that you have to go back from the point, because this much of oxygen is remain in the cylinder, and with reference to this flow rate of this oxygen, that is liters per minute, we have to reach to the safest locations, right? So there may be a chances of leakage, there may be a chances of inhaling more oxygen than the average what we expect, and in that cases we have to reach to the safest location, and for that purpose this warning device is going to operate. So the loss of oxygen from one warning system shall not exceed 0.6 liter per minute at full cylinder pressure. So as an option, an indication of low cylinder pressure is also permitted. Then the flexible tube is another part of this apparatus. So flexible tubes and fittings of the high pressure system shall be capable of withstanding all these types of pressures, right? So to withstand all the types of pressure, we have to use these types of flexible tubes. Then gas cylinder and main valves. So again, with reference to the gas cylinder rule 1981, and with the help of IS standard guidelines, that is IS 3933 1966, we have to use this cylinder for the purpose of storage and supply of this compressed oxygen. The main valve shall comply with the requirements of IS 7302 1974, and shall be so designed that the full pressure in the gas cylinder can't be applied rapidly to the other parts of the apparatus. So this is the basic requirement of this gas cylinder and main valve. Then oxygen supply. So we already discussed that 4 liters per minute, that is the basic requirement of supplying this oxygen. And if the apparatus is supplying less than 2 liters per minute or 1.5 liters per minute, then automatically that demand valve should be operated. And then we can increase the supply at least up to 4 liters per minute. Then there is another part, that is breathing bag. So from the schematic diagram, we have learned that this bag is utilized to mix the oxygen as well as to mix the purified air. And from this bag, we are going to supply this mixed air after cooling for the inhalation purpose. Then this is the details of all these breathing bag. We have already discussed in the schematic diagram itself. Then this breathing tubes shall be flexible and non-kinking and of sufficient length to permit free head movement of the wearer. So this is breathing tubes, not bags. So breathing tubes should be flexible one. So to have the comfortable movement of the wearer's head or the neck, we have to use these breathing tubes, which are flexible one. And again, after the movement, there may be a chances of static charge development. That is why we have to use the anti-static material for these breathing tubes. So this breathing tube shall preferably have a type of connection which enables either a mouthpiece with nose clip or face piece to be fitted. The design of the breathing tubes shall be such as to offer least breathing resistance, and it should be in such a way that in normal use they shall not flatten to impede the flow of gas. The dead space should be as low as possible, and the breathing apparatus carried out at the back of the wearer vein underarm. Deep corrugated tubes are used because when these tubes are linked to the neck or head or face piece, then we have to use these corrugated types of tubes to avoid the damage or leakage or breakages in the tubes. Then the conditions of the inhaled air. So the point one is oxygen contents. So that oxygen content should be tested in accordance with the annexure D. So we will discuss this annexure D in the latter part. And the oxygen content of the inhaled air shall not be below 21% by volume. That is the basic criteria for any type of air. Then carbon dioxide contents, when apparatus is using a mouthpiece or face piece, it should be tested with the help of annexure D and E guidelines. So carbon dioxide content of this inhaled air shall not exceed an average of 1.25% by volume and shall at no time exceeds 1.5% during the working duration of the apparatus. So the maximum percentage of this CO2, that is 1.25 or 1.5. Then the temperature and the humidity. So again, that should be the comfortable one or the suitable one depending on the condition. The examples of this temperature or the comfortable zone is 25 degrees Celsius to 32 degrees Celsius. So if the temperature is very high, then we have to check the apparatus, the material of the apparatus, whether it is having that much of resistance to heat. For example, 45 degrees Celsius is not expected because we are comfortable within the 25 to 32 degrees Celsius temperature. And if the ambient temperature of minus 6 to 3 degrees Celsius, that is also not expected. And if it is the case, then we have to test first that apparatus for that temperature and for high or very low humidity. So this is the table related to the breathing resistances. So what exactly the maximum breathing resistance should be? So the first column indicates the minute volume. The second column indicates the breathing resistance. And under that, the second subcolumn is for the inhalation pressure and for the exhalation pressure in m bar. So for the case, that is the minute volume, 10 respirations per minute into 1 liter per respirations. So that is the case. So for that purpose, the breathing resistance for the inhalation is 1 m bar and for the exhalation is 3 bar is the maximum. So what exactly the maximum breathing resistance, that may be inhalation, that may be exhalation, that depend on the respirations cycles per minute. So likewise, there may be a 20 respirations per minute and 1.5 liters per respiration, or 25 respiration, 30 respirations. Accordingly, the inhalation and exhalation breathing resistance are changed from 1 to 10. So during this machine test, at least 100 liter per minute, the apparatus shall function satisfactorily, right? So this is all about the breathing resistances. Then comfort, we all know that we should feel comfortable while wearing this apparatus, while using this apparatus, and there should not be any harm to our skin or any type of body part. Then purity of oxygen, we know that more than 99% oxygen should be pure. Then pre-flushing device, so apparatus operating with lung supply alone or mixed type with a constant flow of less than 1.5 liters per minute shall be equipped with a device which at the beginning of breathing or at opening of the main valve automatically feeds to 5 to 10 liters of the oxygen into the breathing units. Because if the apparatus is going to supply only 1.5 liters per minute, then we have to flush that oxygen. And that is why it is called as pre-flushing device. So we are going to flush the oxygen at a rate of 5 to 10 liters per minute. Then there may be a saliva trap to accumulate the saliva of the wearer. So if provided, shall be fixed with the inhalation tube. Then protecting casing. So if possible, the whole breathing apparatus shall be covered by the protective casing to protect the breathing bag, regulator, reducing wall, and other vital parts of this apparatus. So it should be made of light metal of adequate strength or a tough molded fiberglass. It shall be so designed that it permits ease of passage through the narrow spaces. So these are the different parts of this apparatus. Now the next point of this IS code is instructions. So what are the instructions to be followed for wearing and using this breathing apparatus? So we have to check the nominal working conditions, guidance on feet of face space, then a warning that adequate protection may not be provided by the apparatus in the certain highly toxic atmospheres, and the guidance should be sought from IS 9623-1980 when we are talking about the highly toxic atmosphere. Then a warning that allowance should be made for the fact that it is likely the facial fit may not be suitable for the persons wearing spectacles. Then a grain size of carbon dioxide adsorbent should be there. So again, IS 5321-1969 is the code who is giving the guidelines related to the carbon dioxide absorbent. Then the next point is related to the marking. So breathing apparatus manufactured in compliance with the standard shall be marked with the different particulars. So the face space shall be marked with the following points like name, trademark, or other means of identification of the manufacturer, size, year, month of manufacturer. Then marking on the apparatus like name, trademark, and other means of identification. Then class 1 or 2 as appropriate. Then working duration with warning device, without warning device, year and month of manufacturer. Then the markings legibly on the breathing bags, breathing tubes, mouthpiece, face piece, and diaphragm. So all these are related to the marking. Now these are the 6 points which are involved under this IS. Now whatever we have discussed, the different parts, that is the annexure. So what exactly the contents of this annexure is? So with reference to the clause 2.1, the list of referred Indian standards are given. So we have to refer this IS 3624-1987 for the pressure and vacuum gauges, and likewise for all these titles we have to refer these IS standards like color identification of gas cylinders IS 3933, soda lime 5321, eye protectors 5983, wall fittings for the gas cylinders 7302, type pressure gauges or automobiles, then 8457 respirator chemical cartridge 8522, respirator canister type or gas mask 8523, and recommendations for selection, use, and maintenance of respiratory protective devices 9623. So this is the annexure which gives us the idea regarding the IS standards for different purposes. Then annexure B with reference to clause 4.1.8 is related to the test for durability of materials when subjected to the cleaning and decontamination. So it is related to the cleaning and decontamination and that test. So in that annexure B, the first part is procedure. So B1, under that subpoint B1.1, components to be tested. So immerse for 10 minutes in the solution of formalin made by the placing 1 part of 40% formaldehyde solution in 9 parts of the water at temperature of 20 degrees Celsius. So that is the testing procedure. So 1 part of formaldehyde and other parts of water at 20 degrees Celsius. Then subjected to moisture and the atmosphere of antiseptic gases, preferably formaldehyde, for a period of 10 minutes at a temperature of 20 degrees Celsius. So this is the testing procedure. Then annexure C with clause 4.2.3, that is the test for the inward leakage of phase space. So under this test or the guidelines, the test subjects are there. Under that, 10 clean shaven persons are selected, covering a broad spectrum of facial characteristics. It is to be expected that exceptionally, some persons can't be satisfactorily fitted with a full face piece. Such exceptional subjects are not used for testing face pieces. So for this purpose, this is the first point for testing the inward leakage of face piece. Then the second point is face piece, that is, if more than one size of face piece is manufactured, the test subjects are supplied with the appropriate size. And the test procedure is, each test subject wearing the face piece under test complete with breathing tubes is enclosed in a plastic hood which is loosely tied around his vest and around the breathing tubes so that the leakage is minimized. And this is regarding the testing, annexure C. So inside of the hood is maintained atmospheric pressure not more than 3 mm water above the atmosphere by supplying the pure argon to the interior of the hood. And then each subject walks on a treadmill at 6.5 km per hour whilst separately carrying out the various head movements and reciting the alphabet. So we are testing, that is why we are intentionally going for the different respiration flow rates. So there may be a different respiration rates, and that is why we are using this treadmill at 6.5 km per hour side by side the head movements. The subjects inhales through a breathing tube from a lung governed oxygen supply and exhales through a breathing tube and sampling bladder to the atmosphere. The amount of argon in the expired gas is determined, for example, by using a mass spectrometer and compared with the argon present with the hood obtained with the face piece leakage. So we are going to check the leakage of that organ, argon, and from this argon leakage, we can identify the leakage in that breathing apparatus or the face piece. Then the annexure D is related to the practical performance test. So with reference to this clause 4.2.8, 4.19.1, 4.19.2.1 and 4.22, the different tests are there for the practical performance. The test subjects include the different points, like breathing apparatus is tested by the test subjects who practice regularly with breathing apparatus. So they have to go on through the medical history also. Then medical attentions, the test shall be carried out under the suspension of registered medical practitioner and the preparation of apparatus to be tested. So we have to check all these compressed oxygen supply, the pressure, the purging method, the different samples, the different ISO standards, etc. And then only we are going to test. So in apparatus using liquid air, the purifier is charged and then we are going to start this apparatus. Then the test procedure is, two kinds of tests are there. One in which two subjects wearing the apparatus walk at a regular rate of 6.5 km per hour on a level course, and one in which two different subjects working in practical conditions. So each test is continuous without removal of the apparatus for a period equal to the working duration of the apparatus, and except that the rest period of 5 minutes are taken after each 15 minutes period. So different tests are there, different subjects are there with different conditions, and after 15 minutes, there is a rest period of 5 minutes, and then they are going to test the situations. So the work simulation test shall be comprised of carrying sandbags over a distance of at least 9 meters and building of the top section of 1.4 meter high stopping. So these are the different work situations in the industries, and that is why they are testing with the work simulation test and with worst situations. So negotiating a circuit of the gallery, which comprises steps and a ramp, then a restricted height carrying from 1.2 to 1.0 meter, a restricted height varying from 0.4 to 1 meter, and an opening of 0.6 meter high into 0.9 meter wide and 3.7 meter long. So these are the different dimensions where the situation may arise, or we have to use this self-contained breathing apparatus for these particular situations. So we have to test first, and after testing and verification, we are going to use this. Then there are different points like carrying, pushing or pulling a stretcher, a dummy body weighing 68 kg around the same circuit of the gallery. And we are using this safety harness, etc. for 75 kg. That is why this dummy body should be less than 75 kg. Then passing sandbags through a steel tube, 3.7 meter long and 0.7 mm diameter, repeated raising the lowering of weight of 25.4 kg to and from a height of 1.8 meter by means of rope and pulley. So climbing over 3.1.2 meter high hurdles, then climbing up and down a vertical ladder with a 460 mm square opening around the ladder, and carrying and building choke or the wooden sleeper pieces in steel air in a climatic chamber where the temperature measured by the hygrometer is dry bulb temperature is 45 degree Fahrenheit and wet bulb temperature is 3 to 5 degrees Celsius lower than the dry bulb. So that is the different conditions of temperature, humidity and the different dimensions or the different bags, and these conditions can be tested in this annexure. So this is D annexure 4.2 points. So during this test period, at the end of each test, the inhaled air is sampled and tested, because we have to check the inhaled air, we have to check the exhaled air, and whether all these through all these conditions, whether the wearer or that subject is comfortable or not. So that can be tested with the different sampling and analysis techniques. Then annexure E is related to the laboratory performance test. So with reference to the clauses 4.17.4 and 4.19.2.1, the guidelines are, the first is general one. This test should be carried out by a lung simulator machine designed to provide the sinusoidal air flows and operating at a rate of 20 respirations per minute. So this is the machine which is designed for this 20 respirations per minute. The second one is lung simulator machine. So the machine delivers to the complete apparatus under the test a tidal volume of 2 liters of 5% by volume carbon dioxide, and the mixture fully saturated at temperature of 37 degrees Celsius. So the total delivery being at a flow of 40 liters per minute, and this test is carried out at this 45 degrees Celsius also. So depending on the relative humidity, so that apparatus is tested for the 85 to 90% humidity also. So maximum humidity, maximum temperature, maximum flow rate, and with the help of that, we are going to test this laboratory performance of this particular machinery. And from this testing, we are going to judge the self-contained breathing apparatus performance. So the in the second point, in a separate test, the sinusoidal air flow is increased to 100 liter per minute. So that is another worst situation. In the case of apparatus in which the material used for absorbing carbon dioxide is contained in a canister or cartridge, The laboratory test is made on the apparatus after the purifier has been subjected for 3 minutes to simulated rough uses as follows. So we have to check the maximum flow rate also. We have to check the absorbent capacity also, because we are going to adsorb the carbon dioxide to purify that air, that is exhaled air. Then canister or cartridges are placed in a tray and arranged so that each has a movement of 6 mm. The tray is then subjected to a horizontal reciprocating machine at a rate between 185 and 190 cycles per minute with a stroke amplitude of 83 mm. So if it is still there, it means that is with it can withstand the different movements of that person. Then the third test for this canister or cartridge. So we have to follow all the guidelines related to this with IS 8522 and IS 8523. Then annexure F is related to the test for inward leakage on relief valve. So with reference to this clause 4.8.1, the test equipment includes a leak tight box connected by a tube to a breathing simulator. So flow test gas is maintained through the box. An instrument is capable of measuring the concentration of the test gas, and the breathing simulator is as specified in this annexure E, operating at a flow rate of 40 liters per minute with a back pressure of 50 mm water. So this is related to the inward leakage test for the relief valve. Then the procedure is given in this F2.1. The wall under the test is fitted in this box with the suitable adapter, and on the expiration stroke, the wall opens and air passes into the box containing the test gas. On the inspiration stroke, the wall closes, and any slip or leakage of the wall allows test gas to pass into the inspiratory airstream. The air is monitored for the test gas concentration. The difference in concentration at this point and at a suitable reference point allows this slip and leakage at this point, and at a suitable reference point allows this slip, and this can be calculated. So leakage can be calculated, the slip can be calculated with the help of this test procedure. So this test is run for a sufficient time to obtain the steady reading of the test gas concentration in the inspiratory air systems. So these are the different annexure, that is A, B, C, D, E, F in this IS, and the different points related to this closed circuit self-contained breathing apparatus. Thank you.